You don't usually see it with family members, but I'm not making an excuse for it, but emotions are running high. You know, this is a pretty heated rivalry. So, yeah, I understand it. You know, at the end of the day, it was just that, you know, emotions running high. But it's usually on the stage, not off.
It flared up within seconds, yeah. And it calmed down just as fast, and everybody's okay, which is great.
Right.
What do you think about the fight itself and the lead-in and everything? Jake Paul?
Look, it's really an intriguing fight. You know, the more, every 5 minutes I think about it, I think something different. You know, and, you know, we don't know how good Jake is. We don't. You know, and so the reality is, you know, we're supporting him with the marketing, and he's got a social media. But at the end of the day, he's only going to go as far as his talent takes him. You know, and that's what I was saying during the press conference. You know, boxing don't lie. You know, he's going to have to live and die on his own talent. You know, and that's going to determine how far he goes.
By the way, what do you think of Pacquiao Ugas? You promoted, you put up Pacquiao fights in the past. So you know him very well. Great person, great human being.
You know what? Look, he's a legend. It's amazing to see him perform even at that level. I was split. I saw Pacquiao fighting in flurries. Look, I don't think it was all Pacquiao's getting old or slowing down. I think Ugas came in with a really good game plan and was really disciplined and physically is the right style. Like, he is the right style and the right build. He's long. He's very disciplined. He's very patient. Doesn't have a ton of power, but if you counter at the right times, it's sort of like, you don't have to be a huge puncher if your timing is on point like his was. So I don't take a lot away about Pacquiao. Like, to me, that said more about Ugas, and, you know, he just fought the fight of his life and had the game plan of his life on that night.
What's next for Gervonta Davis? First of all, he's very lucky and fortunate for that plane crash.
You're right about that. Always scary when something like that happens, but yeah, it was a good thing. You know, thankfully, they detected the problem during takeoff. You know, didn't get off the ground, but still got a little bit rough there. You know, that's the question. Is it's one of those divisions, whether you're talking about 135, which is, you know, primarily what we're thinking about. It's really splintered, so it's tough to make the big fights. It's, you know, no one place has all the opponents, so. You know, right now we're trying to, you know, find who is available, who's willing to do a deal. You know, what's the best available fight? You know, Gervonta definitely wants to get back before the end of the year, and we'd love to do that. We want to keep the momentum going.
Jake called him up.
I saw that. There's been a lot of weight jumping around, but that's about 50 pounds of weight difference. So
the Thurman fight, not serious. Tank and Thurman.
It's an interesting fight to debate. It's sort of fantasy boxing, but the reality is, yeah, the 40 pound is a one-time thing. Like, in 47, you know, Thurman is a good size 47 pounder. Like, you know, that's just from a height length standpoint, that fight doesn't make sense.
I'm sorry.
I mean, it's intriguing to like think about, but realistically, nah.
WBA big announcement yesterday: no more interim. What do you think about that?
I don't mind. I mean, you know, our practice, you know, we didn't really talk about or recognize the interims anyway. And I get it. There are instances, you know, look, if, you know, Errol Spence, if he was going to be out longer or while he was out, like, sometimes it's not fair to take away the title. I get that. There's something to that. But it had ballooned into something else entirely. So I'm in support of it. I give them credit for recognizing the problem and doing something about it, because to be candid, when Gilberto said something about it, I said, oh, okay, you know, now a week later or 2 weeks later, like, he's taken a big step. So he actually stayed true to his word, and he made a difference.
Yesterday you posted a quote from Bruce Lee, said, don't wish for an easy life, wish for the tools to deal with a difficult life. Why do you share that? Is that about boxing? Is that about life?
I think it is. I think it's about life, and it does relate to boxing, you know, because, hey, look, you learn something from every defeat and things like that. But I really believe that, you know, those kind of challenges, it just speaks to me. You know, the challenges build character, you know, and if you talk to anybody who's interesting or who's accomplished, very rarely do they have a simple story. You know, I think the people who have achieved the most, generally speaking, have often overcome the most. Sometimes it's not something obvious, but you know, to me, that's, you know, you're never going to get that wish granted to have an easy life. Like, you know, sure, genie can come along. So you're better off sort of focusing on developing the tools to overcome the difficulties and wishing that they didn't exist.
By the way, before you said, do you know Jorge Capetillo? He coached, he was the cut man for Tyson Fury. He's coaching Tommy Fury.
And
I'm gonna tell you right now, his 9-year-old son will be pound for pound king in a couple of years. He already moves like Pacquiao. He's
Wow.
Showbox.
Good genes.
In 6 years, we'll see him on Showbox.
Good genes. Yeah. To China, WC amateur champion, and it's an honor. And
well, I'm sure Gordon Hall is already scouting him. He's got a folder on him already. I'm sure. So footage and scouting.
To end this interview, Jake Paul hinted that the next fight, if everything works for him and for Tommy, him and Tommy, is that the goal?
I think that's a very strong possibility. It depends how Tommy looks on Saturday night, but you know.